Hello, welcome. In this section, we are going to discuss about what are the three important parameters or how we can represent the expression for a three important parameters in relation with the shaping operation. Like what is the average cutting speed, what is the machining time, and what is the material removal rate. So we are going to see how we can represent the expressions for these three parameters. Before entering into these parameters, first let us see this diagram. This is the schematic representation of a shaping operation that can be performed on a shaper machine. Here, the workpiece is given at the bottom and cutting tool moves over the workpiece in the stroke direction. And the feed is provided by moving the workpiece. The direction of feed is always perpendicular to the cutting speed direction. As I told you initially, we are going to see three terms like average cutting velocity, that is represented by capital V, and machining time, that is represented by T suffix M, and material removal rate, that is MRR. In order to see this expression for these parameters, first let us refer this diagram. Here in this diagram, I have shown the workpiece in pink color and cutting tool I have shown in blue color. And the direction through which the cutting tool moves, that is corresponding to the movement of RAM, that is known as the stroke direction. And the length through which the cutting tool moves, that is the total length through which the cutting tool moves in the stroke direction, that is nothing but capital L. That is the sum of approach length plus over travel length plus cutting length of the workpiece. That is OL plus L plus AL. That is distance through which the cutting tool moves in the stroke direction, that is known as the total length of tool travel in the stroke direction. And you can also see width of the workpiece I have shown as small letter b. And the distance through which the workpiece moves in the feed direction, that is nothing but capital letter b. So total length through which the workpiece moves in the feed direction, that is the sum of approach in the width direction and width of the workpiece and over travel in the width direction. And one more interesting thing is that the direction of feed is always perpendicular to the direction of stroke, and direction of feed is also perpendicular to direction of depth of cut. If you see this diagram, the stroke direction and the feed direction and the depth of cut, these three parameters are mutually perpendicular. And also you can see the depth of cut I have shown in this diagram as small letter D, and feed I have shown the diagram as small letter F. Depth of cut is nothing but what is the distance through which the cutting tool penetrates into the workpiece. In this case, in the downward direction, that is known as the depth of cut. And feed is nothing but how much distance the workpiece moves in the feed direction by completing one full stroke. By following this diagram, we need to see what are the expressions for average cutting velocity, what is the machining time, and what is the material removal rate. We can see one by one. First, we are going to see what is average cutting velocity V. V is equal to Ln into 1 plus K divided by 1000 and representing in meter per minute, where capital L is equal to length of RAM stroke in millimeter and capital N is equal to number of double stroke per minute or number of full stroke per minute. That is, by consuming duration of 1 minute, how much number of stroke is or full stroke is completed. That's nothing but capital letter N. And K is equal to cutting speed divided by return speed or return time divided by cutting time. The value of K is always less than 1. Why? Because cutting speed is always less than return speed, or we can say return time is always less than cutting time. Suppose if there is a problem, in that problem there is no way we can calculate the value of K, that is cutting speed and return speed is not available and return time and cutting time is not available, and also K value is not mentioned directly, we can take it as 1. Otherwise, we need to find the value of K and it should be less than 1, that we need to substitute in the expression. And you can also see that the expression for capital letter L, that is length of RAM stroke, that is equal to L plus AL plus OL, where L is equal to, smaller L is equal to length of workpiece in millimeter and AL is equal to length of tool approach in length direction in millimeter and OL is equal to length of tool over travel in the length direction in millimeter. That is, if you refer this diagram, capital L is equal to OL plus L plus AL in the direction of stroke. So it is clear that expression for average cutting velocity V is equal to LN into 1 plus K divided by 1000. Normally, we are substituting length is in millimeter. If we are dividing the length in millimeter divided by 1000, it is become meter. That is why we are getting the unit is in meter per minute. The next parameter we are going to discuss over here is machining time. Machine time Tm equal to N into B divided by Fn. The unit of machining time is minute, where capital B is equal to length of tool travel in the width direction, or we can say in the feed direction in millimeter, and F is equal to feed per stroke. The unit is millimeter per stroke, where capital B is equal to B plus AB plus OB, where smaller B is equal to width of the workpiece in millimeter, AB is equal to length of tool approach in the width direction in millimeter, OB is equal to length of tool over travel in the width direction in millimeter. That is, if you refer this diagram, capital B is equal to AB plus B plus OB in the feed direction. So it is clear that the expression for machine time is equal to N into B divided by Fn, where smaller n is equal to number of cut required to complete the operation. That is, if you are removing one layer of material, then again we are performing one more operation to remove another layer of material, there are two number of cuts. So we can substitute n is equal to 2. But if we can able to perform the operation by removing one layer of material, we can substitute n is equal to 1. Finally, one more. What is material removal rate? We can say MRR. The expression for MRR equal to F into D into L into N. And it is represented in millimeter cube per minute. So what is meant by MRR or a material removal rate? MRR is nothing but what is the amount of or what is the volume of material removed by machining operation in a unit time. That is millimeter cube per minute. If you are machining for a 1 minute of duration, how much quantity or how much volume of material removed in millimeter cube? That is nothing but MRR, where F is equal to feed per stroke in millimeter per stroke, D is equal to depth of cut in millimeter, L is equal to smaller L is equal to length of workpiece in millimeter, and capital N is equal to number of double stroke per minute or number of full stroke per minute. So I am going to conclude this video. We discussed about three parameters. The expression for average velocity is ln into 1 plus k divided by 1000. And the expression for machining time is n into b by fn. And the equation for MRR equal to f into d into l into n.